A welcome! I am the Munchin King to you! Happy Thanksgiving. I have a potato in my trousers, Bobby Metal. Gimme chocolate! I believe the two exclamation marks are officially part of the title. I have seen while scrolling, they all include two exclamation points, and I was going to just put one! What a tragedy that would have been. Travesty for me. The Late Show, Stephen Colbert. A USA program. Very late for me! I have waited a long time for this moment, as have some of you. This was I will speak from memory from what I recall, that this was a very extraordinary performance for sure, because I heard they wanted control, the US sneaky people. No offense to you. They wanted all the control over the sound management, the production behind the scenes, but Bobby Metal said, "No to you!" But they insisted, and then they said, "No to me!" And then they insisted, and then they said, "Never ever will we perform at your stupid venue, unless we have full control of our crimes." And so, the US, whoever they're called, the people, they said, "Okay, Bobby Metal, you can come here. You do what you want to do to you, and we will just watch and pray for the best, shall we?" Another thing I'd like to point out is that it's a very small stage. It always is on The Late Show. I've seen performances here before, and I'm quite excited about that because that's something that I wanted to see last time in my reaction to the music video called... I don't remember what that song was called, but they were in a dojo-looking place. They had traditional clothing and traditional instruments, it looked like. And people with fox masks, and I thought it was the band. But I was informed that my illusion was incorrect. It was not the band, they were just dancers. Pretending. Pretense is a great era of society. However, this is actually the band and the singers together. Together as one, because usually we don't see them together. They are always hidden, and of course they are at the front. And another thing that came to my attention, I believe it was Richard Townsend who told me that we will see Mikio very clearly and smiling. I always miss Mikio, and when I do see him, his smile is covered in hair. And then it cuts away. So, let's witness. 4 minutes long. How do you do to you? 3, 2, 1, go.
I'm not sure what I'm about to see.
You be respectful to me.
But I'm pretty excited about
he
it.
He looks like an
if
elf for sure.
Give me chocolate. Please welcome Baby Metal.
No, he is Spock. He is Spock to me. And here's the reveal for sure. I am looking forward to this! Oh, I thought they were about to fall over. Here we are! Look at them in their glory! I've not heard this song before, by the way. Look at their glory! For sure. I will follow you to you. This is so cool to witness them like this. Which one is Mikio? Is it the pink guitar? No, it's not. It's the one on the left. The smiling one on the left is Mickey O, for sure. I witness you. Let me put the volume up. This video seems a bit lower. Crazy to me! They must have been very... I'm not sure what they must have been feeling before this performance. Have they performed in the US before this performance? Or perhaps this was just their first television performance in the US. But maybe they've been on tour, in concert before this. Gimme chocolate! Very fast to me. I cannot keep up. Ah, yes, I did remember a comment. They said they loved seeing that they sang along to the song. The drummer, my memory. Look at them, headbanging, for sure. Mickey O! This is your shiny time. He is very worthy to me. What is this? I like that move. Going around like a little child, for sure. She seems different today, Sue Metal. This isn't the usual sort of facial expression. She looks a bit looser in this performance. Her face. Usually she's very stern. Seems a lot more fun, her spirit, in this performance. Mickey O is a very smiley man indeed. What a show. Bravo to you, for sure. Bravo. Thank you to you. Wow. That was a great little set for me, wasn't it? This was a legendary performance. I thought he didn't know what he was about to see, and yet he had a record right there in his hand. I wonder if he even listened to it, creepy man, for sure. Anyway. That's what I liked to see. Finally got to see the band and those three girls together. They were still at the front, of course, but we got to see them all. And even when it cut away from them, it didn't seem like it was taking away from the performance. I know in my first ever reaction, Road of Resistance, I got a bit frustrated when it cut away from the dancers to focus on the band, much to many viewers' surprise. But here, it seemed I did not even think about it. It was just great to see everyone got their moment, for sure. Got their shots. And there was a lot of dancing in this. There was a very energetic, very lively, very cheeky sort of performance. Sue Metal, you know, every performance I've seen, she's been sort of, you know, in the name of Road of Resistance, all of them really. She's been sort of this elevated figure, sort of like the queen figure, like the warrior sort of aura about her. But in this performance was very different, I would say. Out of the ones that I have seen, and I've seen 17, maybe 18 now. Maybe this is my 18th, I'm not sure. But this one, she seemed very much like the other two on sort of a level playing field. She didn't... I suppose she didn't stand out as much as she usually does in that way. She didn't have the posture, the stature she usually has. It was very much sort of a celebration of them all together. They really meshed in this performance because she seemed, her personality seemed more like the others. Usually she looks very stern. She has a very solid face. A very rigid face, emotionless, or except for the emotion. I shouldn't say emotionless, but like a warrior expression, and certainly in the songs, I'm not good with names, but there's a song where it's just her singing, and it's a very great, just focusing on her vocals, and it's emotional for sure. But her standard upbeat tracks, I say her tracks, all of their tracks, the heavy tracks, she has that fearless sort of aura about her. This one, she seemed happier, physically on her face. She seemed cheekier. She was more like the other two who have smiles and like joyful and youthful. That was it. She seemed more youthful in this performance, like the others. And even the band, getting to witness them. Really for the first time, just close, and for this lingering duration. We really got to see their personalities. Mikio. This was really the first time I got to get a good look at Mikio. And finally I got to be exposed to what Richard has been telling me since the beginning. His smiling, undeniable features, for sure. A great loss to the community, a great loss to the band, a great loss to the spirit of the living. Rest in peace to you! For sure. This guy, very different features to Mikio, of course. He looks very, how you would expect, I suppose, a guy in this sort of band to behave in their facial procedures. And then, of course, we saw the drummer. Never really noticed the drummer before, but we got to see the drummer. I noticed this guy before because he's bald, but the drummer, we got to see him singing along, enjoying himself there, and there was someone else, I'm not sure what their name is, on the bassist, the bass, I guess, or maybe I'm wrong, he looks like he's on the bass, so the other guitarist, we got to see them all together. I do wonder what they must have been feeling at this time. Probably great joy that they are on such a big platform in the US. They are being exposed to a massive audience for the first time, I suspect. As I said, I don't know if they've been on tour before this. I suspect they must have been if they were picked up by the station. I doubt they picked them up from Japan and just said, oh, this is a popular band in Japan, let's bring them over. But maybe that's how it went. I suspect they did tour in the US and maybe someone saw them and suggested that they would be a good entry on this show. But, iconic! They must have been very proud moment. A very apprehensive, exciting, and a great time. Great opportunity. I never heard about Baby Metal before. I did my first reaction on YouTube. I saw someone else reacted to them. I didn't watch the video, but I saw it was popular and I thought, why not? Why not see what it's all about? So here we are. And I'm so glad that I did, because they are very funky to me. Tell me your thoughts on these crimes. Show me your commitment to your pineapples. And remember the 5th of November. Jump on that subscribe button if you would like to eat the cheese. Farewell, my munchins. Take care, my munchins.